Hey guys, Wake Rider here, playing a little bit of Rush on Sharky Peninsula, and using the ACWR with the engineering class, of course, and this is actually one of the Wake Titans servers. So my buddy Jamie made a server for me, it's called Wake Titans. I think it just expired, but he should be renewing it shortly, and if I'm not playing on my server, or my buddy Ruskoff's server, then you can probably find me on here. I know a lot of people say that my server is empty. Depending on what playtime, I usually have to start it myself, and if I'm only going to hop on for half an hour, I'm not going to spend, 5 to 10 minutes trying to jumpstart my own server. So with that being said as well, I will be looking for new server admins. So I know I did this once before, it worked very well, but for you guys, especially out of the country, who want to be a server admin, I'll be more than happy to give you access to my server and make you an admin. The only really things I ask are the same things as before, is to not touch any playlist that says Wake on it, because that's a playlist that I personally made. And then if you do change the playlist away from vanilla, to change it back to vanilla before you leave the server for the day. And don't kick anybody until you send them a message first, and then if they continue to do whatever it is that you don't want them to do, then at that point you can kick them. Really, the only rule I have is no C4 on close quarters domination objectives. But other than that, you're all good. I think there's, just a plethora of servers out there now that have too many rules. I saw one the other day that the rules for the server were like longer than the manual of how to control tanks in Battlefield. I was like, okay, no shotguns, no C4s, no claymores, no stingers, no iglas, no laser-guided javelins. So what are we doing? Are we basically just going to run around with knives? Or are knives too OP too? So I didn't quite understand that. I was just like, okay. And I think I got kicked out of that server pretty much right away. I'm sure I violated some rule, like I used a secondary, or or maybe something like I used a primary weapon. It says no primary weapons allowed right in the server description. How can you violate that? So I think we all pretty much know there's like just a ridiculous amount of rules and regulations that these wannabe server admins are making, and any dick with like $20 to get rent a server for a month can basically, kick out anybody he wants at his leisure. So at that point also, I have been playing on Battlefield servers a lot lately, and especially when I play Rush, because, the thing with Rush is it's really, and this is a good example of this, because this was actually a 200% Rush game. It's just too long. At this point here, with a 200% server, the attacking team definitely has the leg up, and the defending team is hard pressed, because realistically, if you can't cap an objective in 200 tickets, come on, man, that's just absolutely ridiculous. So I prefer to play 100% Rush server. So when I do play that, I usually play on Battlefield servers, just because I know there's no malarkey going on and there's no shadiness going on. I'm not gonna get kicked because my team's about to win, or I'm not gonna get kicked because I keep PTFOing the objective. And also I don't have to worry about the tickets, because I know there'll be normal tickets, because sometimes they say in the description that it is normal tickets, and then you get in there and it's like 300% tickets, and you're like, what the hell, why am I playing a Rush game for an hour and a half? Rush games should be like no more than 20 minutes. So, and that's a long Rush game. Rush games should really be anywhere from like 10 to 15 minutes. So basically I'm using the ACWR here as well. And I'm not really, I think I already did like a little review-ish thing on it. So I didn't really put the stats at the beginning. And I'm only going to do that like once, or for every weapon that I use when it's a new, my new time for using that weapon. Or if I have something specifically to say about this weapon. Really, the only thing I want to touch on the ACWR is that basically I am using it with a suppressor. Do not use it with a suppressor. If you'll see in this gameplay, it takes a long time to hit the kill. It's a little ridiculous. So I actually usually use the ACWR with either a flash suppressor or a heavy barrel. I would recommend probably the flash suppressor. The regular suppressor on this is just too much, and it nerfs it just a little bit. So you can see here, I'm sneaking up the side of this hill, just raining havoc on these camping snipers.
He's heating up!
A little bit of NBA jams for you. See how many 90s kids are out there are watching my videos. But it's just all campus. Like, they all switched to recon all of a sudden.
Boom shakalaka! He's on fire!
So, I never really understood that. It's like, you know, I don't understand in Rush how you're supposed to be able to push up by not pushing up. And it's kind of the opposite of what the core of Rush is really all about. Like, if you're in trouble in Rush, you should put your recon class on, okay? But more importantly than that, you should use your spawn beacons in a tactical manner. So, I mean, me, when I know my team's in trouble and I gotta put them on my back, I switch over to recon, I put the spawn beacon out, I put the spawn beacon no more than like 20 meters away from the objective in some obscure location that the enemy team is sure not to find it. So my spawn mates can spawn on me, and then we can go ahead and cap the objective and hopefully take home the W. So for somebody to spawn in at the top of the hill, camping in a building, you know, with like a semi-automatic marksman rifle, like a SKS or an EMR or something like that, it's just ridiculous. I mean, how is that helping your team out? Obviously, there weren't that many recon guys at the beginning of this gameplay, so and that's really why I wanted to show you that little tidbit right there.
Is it the shoes?
But, you know, I mean, and so all of a sudden, it's like the second set of objectives. There's a million of these sons of bitches. They're coming out of the woodwork. So I did not quite understand that. And that's one of the reasons why on this second MCOM, I really just started slaying the shit out of these guys. Now, on the first set of MCOMs, the tank, like, owned my ass. So, of course, I'm an engineer, and I'm trying to RPG and take it out as quickly as possible. And I'm launching RPGs at it, and the next thing I know, you know, the tank just casually turns around and, you know, blasts his main cannon at me, and I'm done. So, initially, this was actually about a 30-minute gameplay, which I've actually whittled down now to about 10 minutes. And that 10 minutes, this whole 10 minutes, as you can see so far, has been pretty high action. So there wasn't like a really resting moment where I was like, okay, I'm just gonna hang back here and, you know, I'm gonna protect this area or anything like that. I just don't personally play like that. I know there are a lot of YouTubers out there who are like, I did a good job protecting the C flag this game. And, you know, it's like they're camping in the, you know, the freaking, see how no shark canals are camping in the containers, or, you know, on Operation Metro, they're camping behind the MCOMs in the rocks or something like that. It's just like, you know, come on, man. It's like, how is that fun to you? I mean, I don't even have like ADD or ADHD. I don't even have any of that stuff, but I still get super bored just sitting back, resting on my laurels, like waiting for people to come at me. I just don't understand. Personally, like, the point of a video game is to have fun. So, you know what? Try to push your limits a little bit. Try to have a little fun. And go out there, grab them by the balls, and take it away from them. I don't know how to say that bluntly enough. It says, I just don't get it. And you see a lot of people, you know, whether they're casual players that you just happen to run into on servers, or whether they're YouTube commentators, or whether, you know, occasionally a squad mate, or whatever the case may be. Now, I will tell you that most people that I play with, these guys here, Dawn of Death, Laguna, and Kaboom, I play with them a lot, and none of these guys are camping in the back of the map for anything. They're all go-getters. They all want to go out and try to rack up as many points as they can, whether it be defusing, arming, or getting kills, or, you know, getting into a helicopter or something like that, or a tank, and then racking up as many points as it can. Because this is a point-based game, and you're not going to get any points camping in the back of the map with a recon class on Rush. I don't know. I think I've beat that dead dog enough, so. But one of the amazing things about this ACWR, it does have very little recoil. And I know they did nerf it a little while ago and made the recoil slightly more, but especially with the heavy barrel on it, it still tends to have very little recoil. And this guy right here just got a bad spawn. And that's actually my, I was just like, I'm just gonna go ahead and knife this guy. What the hell? And then I end up dying, so. But I think I got revived at the very, very last second there. So I got my ass kicked by the tank in the first set of MCOMs, but obviously the second set I pwned everybody. Ended up 68-18, took home almost 11,000 points, PTFO, slain. Hey, why not? So let me know what you guys think, and what your frustrations are, if you've ever, you know, run into those recon guys and rush sitting in the back of the map doing jack shit, or if you are one of those guys. So I'll talk to you guys soon. Thanks for watching. Thank you.